everybody. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. May the good Lord bless you and guide you and protect you. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Our topic today is love is kind. We will read from the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 4. I'm using NIV Bible today. Today's word, you may have heard this verse many times before, but one translation says that love looks for a way to be constructive. In other words, kindness isn't just about being nice. It's looking for ways to improve someone else's life. It brings out the best in others. When you start your day, don't just spend time thinking about yourself or how you can make your own life better. Think about ways you can make someone else's life better too. Ask yourself, who can I encourage today? Who can I build up? You have something to offer those around you that no one else can give. Someone in your life needs your encouragement. Someone in your life needs to know that you believe in them. We are responsible for how we treat the people He's blessed in our lives. He's counting on us to bring out the best in our family and friends. Today, ask the Lord to give you creative ways to encourage those around you. As you sow seeds of encouragement and bring out the best in others, God will send people along your path that will build you up too. Keep sowing kindness so you can move forward into the blessing and freedom He has for you. Let us pray before we continue. Father God, thank you for loving me. Thank you for believing in me and always building me up. I ask that you show me creative ways to encourage and build up the people around me. Help me to be an example of your love today and always, in Jesus' name. I just want to talk to you today about being good to people. Everywhere we go, we should look for opportunities to be a blessing. Doesn't have to be something big. You bring your okay cup of coffee in the morning, a small act of kindness. Or on the freeway, traffic backs up. You slow down. You let that car in your front to move. Just being good to people. At the grocery store, the person behind you has fewer items. You tell them, go up ahead in front of me. Do good to people. Value people. You don't have to. There is nothing wrong if you don't, but you're on the lookout for ways that you can be good to people. We always ask God for blessing. You have to be a blessing to somebody. I've learned if you make somebody else's day, God will always make your own day. If you bring a smile to their face, God will bring a smile to your face too. And this is the most rewarding way to live. Not what can I get, but what can I give. Not what can you do for me, but what can I do for you. The scripture says, Jesus went about doing good, healing all that were sick. The first thing Jesus did before healing, before ministering, before delivering, was He was good to people. And we all have an assignment. You could say we have all a ministry, may not be up in front of people, may not be to go to missionaries overseas. Our ministry is to be good to people. That's one of the best witnesses that we could ever have. You don't have to necessarily preach them a sermon. You don't have to argue doctrine. Try to make them believe what you believe. Just be good to them. Our actions speak much louder than our words. We can say all day long, I love you. But true love is seen in what we do. If I really love you, I'll be good to you. If I really love you, I will let you have the parking spot even though I got there first. I'll prefer you. God said to Abraham, I will bless you and you will be a blessing. One key to be blessed is, are you willing to be a blessing? God is not going to increase us in the way He wants if we don't make it a priority to be good to people. Okay, I met an older woman. She always come to the hospital. One day, I served a conversation with her. I was asking her, "How are you feeling, ma? What is really going on now in your home and in your heart?" He said, "Hey, doctor, you are so kind. You are so good. You don't even look at how you are, but you come down to me and be asking me." I say, "Yes, ma'am, I care. If there is anything I can do for you, please don't hesitate to tell me. I will do it." Amen. Amen. Friends, being good to people is better than preaching a sermon. Being kind, generous, compassionate speaks much louder than any words. And we should have a goal every day to do at least one good thing for somebody else. Don't wait for a special occasion. Don't. It doesn't have to be Christmas, their birthday, their anniversary, Valentine's. No, just an ordinary day. Bring your spouse home some flowers. Give your wife something that will make her happy. You are at the mall and you see that blouse that will look good on your friend. Buy it and take it to her. What's this for? It's not my birthday. It's not Christmas. No. It's because you're my friend. I want to be good to you. That young man that sells pizza or delivers pizza to your house, you don't even really know him, but sometimes for no reason at all, bless him with an extra money. You can't be good to everyone, but you can be good to the people God put in your life. You need to study them, listen to what they are saying, be sensitive to their needs. This is showing love. Value people. Anytime you value people, Almighty God will bless you. The book of Galatians chapter 6 verse 10 says, "Don't miss an opportunity to be good to people." If I wouldn't have been sensitive, not only would me or the woman not be blessed, but when you are good to people, you are sowing a seed for God to be good to you. I would have missed out on a blessing day if I didn't do that. Okay? So just be good to people. Just be good. The more you bless others, the more God blesses you. In anything you want to do, whatever you just want to do, God will bless you. The real joy in life is not in what we get, but in what we give. There is no greater feeling than in making somebody's day. We were never created to be ingrown and think about me and my dreams and my problems and my challenges. It's why some people are not happy. We were created to be givers. And when we help make somebody's dream come to pass, God will always make your own come to pass. Proverbs 11:17 puts it this way. Your own soul is nourished when you are kind. That is Proverbs 11:17. When you are good to others, yes, you are doing them a favor. Quite all right. But really, you are doing yourself a favor. Do you know that? Your own soul is being strengthened. Your own life is being enriched. It's like this. The word of God I was just telling people about in the book of 2 Corinthians, Paul said in 2 Corinthians, "I want you to excel in the gracious ministry of giving." Okay? He couldn't have said it. "I want you to excel in business, excel in sports, excel in medicine." That's all good. But he said, "What I want you to really be great at, what I want you to excel in, is giving." Thank you very much for listening to me. May the good Lord bless you. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.